This is lesson 12 of the Simple Machines unit. This one lesson is about the changing the slope experiment. This is one of the most important activities you're going to do in this unit. You're going to work in a group to do an experiment to figure out a pattern in nature and then make a prediction based on what you found out. The system you use to make a prediction is called a theory. So you're actually going to make a theory on the amount of force it takes to move something up a slope. I thought you'd like to see this diagram that was made about 100 years ago showing the number of horses it takes to pull a fully loaded wagon up a slope. That's sort of what you're going to be figuring out. So here's the task. You're going to predict the force required to move a weight up a slope. You're going to do that by measuring the force at three different places three different slopes. Two inclined slopes, meaning they're going up, and on the flat. So a total of three surfaces or three little experiments. And then you're going to use that information to predict the force for a different slope that you haven't measured so far. You're going to predict what you think the slope will be, and you're going to tell us how you figured that out, what your theory was. Do you remember how we measure the slope of an inclined plane? We can create a ratio or a couple of numbers to measure the slope. Do you remember the rise and run? If you're not sure what it is, look back in your notes and make sure you know. Can you think of a good way to easily adjust the slope so that you can do the measurements and do the tests easily? How are you going to actually measure the slope? Here's some things to think about. How will we correct for friction? What two slopes will you measure on, and which slope will you use to predict? What things will you need to control for? For example, the surface and the weight is easy to make to control for and make it the same. But how will you correct for the speed? How will you make that the same? So those are the big questions you need to do. Just a little extra, you won't be able to control for everything. For example, in this experiment, I don't think weather will make any difference unless you're doing it outside or something like that. So you've got to decide which things are important in the experiment and which things you're not going to bother about because you don't have enough time. You can see why it's important that you've done this experiment a few times, because now you know, or you have a better idea of what it takes to do a good experiment here. Good luck.